we are asked to evaluate the given definite integral. To perform integration, we will have to use the method of substitution. Looking at the integrand function, because we have the exponential function with base e, we will let u equal the exponent of 1 divided by x to the fourth. So if u is equal to 1 divided by x to the fourth, we know we need to find differential u, so let's write 1 divided by x to the fourth as x raised to the power of negative 4. So differential u is equal to the derivative of x raised to the power of negative 4 with respect to x times dx, which would be negative 4 times x raised to the power of negative 4 minus 1, which is negative 5, times dx. Because the integrand function does not contain a factor of negative 4, for the next step we will divide both sides by negative 4. And now we simplify. On the left we have negative 1/4 du equals, on the right, negative 4 divided by negative 4 is equal to 1. So we have x raised to the power of negative 5 times dx. Looking back at the integral though, because we have x raised to the power of positive 5 in the denominator, let's write x to the power of negative 5 as 1 divided by x to the fifth, and then we have times dx. Now we can perform the substitution. Beginning with the given integral, we will substitute u for 1 divided by x to the fourth here in the exponent. And if it's helpful, we can place a 1 here, because negative 1/4 du equals 1 divided by x to the fifth dx, we will substitute negative 1/4 du for the fraction of 1 over x to the fifth times dx. Let's write this integral temporarily without the limits of integration in terms of u. We'd have the integral of, this would be e to the u, and then again, 1 over x to the fifth dx is equal to negative 1/4 du. We factor out the negative 1/4, and we have differential u. The antiderivative with respect to u is negative 1/4 e to the u, which means with respect to x, we would have negative 1/4, not e to the u, but e raised to the power of 1 divided by x to the fourth. And because we have a definite integral, we will now determine big F of b minus big F of a using the limits of integration. Let's go ahead and factor out the negative 1/4. So we have negative 1/4 times, when x is equal to 2, we have e raised to the power of 1 divided by 2 to the fourth, and then minus, when x is 1, we have e raised to the power of 1 divided by 1 to the fourth. Simplifying, we have negative 1/4 times e raised to the power of, well, 2 to the fourth is 16, so e to the 1/16 minus 1 to the fourth is just 1, so we have minus e to the 1. So the exact value of the definite integral is negative 1/4 times the quantity e raised to the power of 1/16 minus e, plus also get our decimal approximation. So we enter negative 1/4 times the quantity e. If we press second ln, it brings up e raised to the power of, and the exponent is 1/16, so 1 divided by 16, right arrow, minus. For just e, we can press second divide, close parenthesis, and enter. To four decimal places, the value is approximately 0.4134. I hope you found this helpful.